What's up? This is Brett Scallions with Fuel. You got it tuned in right here, loud and proud, with Brigade Radio 1.
You're listening to Brigade Radio 1.
Of all your projects and the legends that you've worked with, you had told us once before that you struck up genuine friendships with both Laurence Olivier and Charlton Heston.
Oh, very much so.
Yes, and yes. You at one point took Laurence Olivier. Frank Sinatra had asked you if you could introduce him to Laurence Olivier at one of his cocktail parties, and you took Laurence.
And I took him along.
And you took him along.
And up to that hill, he lived on the top of a hill, you know.
The Chateau Marmont, right?
Well, we lived at the Chateau Marmont, Larry, Olivier, and myself. And,
Larry.
Yeah.
Larry.
Well, that's what everybody called him, right? Yeah.
And Frank had a sort of hilltop home. Quite remember, but in the hills.
Was that the house where he would hoist the Jack Daniels flag, meaning he was home? Mm. Or was that the Palm Springs house? He literally did that.
Literally?
He did that.
Yeah, yes.
Like the Queen, yes.
Yeah. I remember one time, because he was showing me around the house, and in the bedroom were two very tall cabinets beside each side of the bed. I said, well, what's that for? He said, oh, Richard, those are where I keep the... armaments to repel invaders. what do you mean by that? He opened them up, and there were the rifle. I'd stuck a rifle, whatever, you know.
He did have an armory.
He said, can you shoot Richard? I said, well, not, yeah, I've done a bit, you know. Well, let's see how good you are. So we went, he said, he gave us me a rifle, and he took one himself. We went out into the back garden.
Had you already started drinking at this time, or did you already have cocktails before you went to the rifle range? Just a quick question.
Quite early in the evening.
It's like a politically correct world now.
Booze and bullets together. It all works.
So we went out into the garden at the back and said, well, you see those lights at the base of the palm trees over there? Let's see how many we can shoot at.
This is how Sinatra rolled, huh?
Wow.
We took turns in. He said, we'll have six shots each. Oh, okay, fine. And so I shot out six. He shot out four. I'm not sure he didn't look at me. You know, I'm not allowed to say the word he used, but you freaking, something like that.
Yeah.
Limey. How did you learn to shoot like that?
And you told him you had to shoot Messerschmitts down, you know, and America didn't have that problem.
They didn't know that.
No.
But he, it always struck me as, you know, a pretty extraordinary, well, a extraordinary thing to be doing at 2 o'clock in the morning, anyway, in the middle of a party. Secondly, it was... this hill in Beverly Hills, I mean, one of the Beverly Hills, presumably, and you know what the neighbors must have thought about the...
They were probably used to it.
They probably were. The gunfire everywhere around the hills.
And the cussing, yeah.
Chateau Sinatra.
Chateau Sinatra.
Anyway, no, but he was a wonderfully amusing and outrageous guy.
Wow.
As people know, you know. Mm. But, a good friend, as long as he lasted, you know, as long as you lasted a friend, he was a wonderful friend. But he was extraordinarily touching. You know that terrible thing that happened to poor Sammy? That Sammy, who was worshipped Sinatra and was a friend, you know, terrific.
Sammy Davis Jr.
And Sammy Davis, yes. And he and Sinatra, for some reason, didn't... Sammy didn't know why. I mean, he complained to me about it. I don't know why. But he's sort of banned me. He was banned from the Sinatra Society. And he was really, really upset about it. But he didn't know why it had happened, because he couldn't talk to Sinatra. Not even talk to him.
Robert Osborne of Turner Classic Movies had said that Sammy was supposed to play the Charles Bronson film in a the Charles Bronson role in your film that you did with him, Never So Few, with McQueen.
Was he?
And that it was something over something. Sammy let something slip on the radio is the story that they were putting out on Turner Classic Movies. Uh-huh. And it's interesting that you bring that up because they just showed that movie. They've been showing Never So Few on Turner Classic Movies. Have you tuned into it?
No.
You don't, but you do get the residual check, right?
I didn't know it was on. But anyway, I
could swear.
You know, it's something. There's something about old movies when you look at them and you're in them. I find... not terribly attractive.
I could swear.
It's like we're embalmed at that age, basically.
Exactly,
right?
That's right. You're like a fly in amber.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Forever.
Yeah, exactly. At that age, yes. Yeah.
You better subscribe to this channel before you look uncool. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Hey everyone, it's Ethan, the executive director here at Brigade Radio 1. As many of you know, we produce a lot of radio content with people like director Michael Lang of Bones and X-Files, director Steve Sergic of Lost in Space, Daredevil, Luke Cage. We work with a lot of producers as well, from Cindy Caponera of Shameless to Jason Schumann of Role Models to Eric Linus Kaplan of Futurama and Big Bang Theory. What we need is partnership. Go to patreon.com/BrigadeRadio1. Become a partner today. Score yourself some concert tickets, VIP access, behind-the-scenes footage, and all kinds of other craziness. Get involved. Become a partner. Help us not only deliver great radio content, but also help make the world a better place. Go to patreon.com/BrigadeRadio1.